back to today's video. Today we are going to be doing a 40 subscriber appreciation video, so thank you guys for allowing my channel to hit 40 subscribers. So In honor of that, I brought in a very special guest, and we are going to be talking about a topic that is near and dear to our hearts, which is the Disney Pixar Cars franchise. The special guest is Bailey from my Red Dead videos and my Art After Dark video.
Hey guys!
So, what do you want to start off with for the franchise, about talking about it?
Well, since we're talking about it, how do you honestly feel about the franchise?
To be completely honest, I feel like the Cars 1 is the best out of all three of them.
And I agree. It is the best. One pro I would say is the characters. They have their own personal point of views through McQueen, and what's really amazing is how McQueen started his own relationships with each of the characters and the storyline itself. One con is I really didn't like how some of it could have been inappropriate, especially with me and Tia. So, what do you think?
Yeah, I do agree. Some parts could be fixed, but overall, I believe the first one could be the best, in my opinion. In general, the franchise, I think it could be better because I believe the second and third movies weren't revolved around the main character, which was Lightning McQueen.
Yeah. Another thing is, let's talk about characters. What's your favorite character, Jack?
My favorite character is Strip Weathers, who is voiced by Richard Petty. Richard Petty is my favorite stock car racer, and he was a very famous one at that in the 60s and 70s when they were using actual, like, almost stock cars from the dealerships.
Yeah, my personal favorite, everyone likes him, it's Lightning McQueen. I like him because he represents pretty much all of us. We have a journey ahead of us, and he had his journey, and he learned valuable lessons throughout the story, and I think we're gonna provide the same teachings with other people in the real world, and I thought he was a true inspiration to represent all of us, so, yeah.
So, do you have anything bad to say about Cars 1? So, cons?
There's some changes that I would recommend. Definitely add more Strip Weathers in there, because here's why. Strip gave him an advice. He's a legendary racer, but he only gets a few scripts inside the movie, and he was more as a side character than like a important character, so definitely add more Weathers in there. So what do you say?
Yeah, I believe that they should have added more Strip Weathers because I believe he was more of a main character than some of the other characters, because yet he is also a stock car racer. He should have had more lines. We should have been able to hear his entire pep talk with Lightning before he daydreamed. We only heard about 5 or 6 seconds of his pep talk before McQueen daydreamed. But what I don't understand is how Strip Weathers didn't notice that McQueen was daydreaming.
Mm-hmm. So now we have, like, Cars 1 out of the box here. Now let's look at Cars 2 and 3. So, Cars 2, what do you think of it?
Cars 2, I did like parts of it. But overall, probably out of 10, I would rate it probably 5 or 6, between 5 and 4 or 6.
I kind of liked it. Well, it's a kind of movie I would watch like once in a while, not like all the time. I really honestly loved Finn, the way he was introduced. However, what I didn't like, it was more a Mater and less McQueen. Because
yeah.
McQueen was a target, and Mater was more of, oh, I'm a spy now, but I'm a tow truck. I don't know how it works. Oh,
yeah.
Let me get in the way of the whole story. It's all about me, me, me. So
I found that Cars 2 for me is usually is underwhelming.
I agree. Yeah.
Not the entire movie, but some parts.
Yeah. It was more spy stuff, like James Bond, rather than racing.
I agree.
It just probably, I would give it like 2-3 star, sort of, on it.
Yeah, I'd give like 2.5-3 stars on it.
Yeah. All right, now the finale. Cars 3.
The
gosh.
Only parts that I liked about Cars 3 was about when they reintroduced Doc at some parts. Where they showed McQueen being trained by him, some deleted scenes from the first movie.
Yeah. Definitely.
Some of the quotes he said, that Paul Newman said from who voiced Doc, and that part where McQueen was jumping and the like the paint or whatever the livery was flying off of him in the moonlight.
Oh yeah, that was a pretty nice one. One thing that I liked about it was how McQueen was able to face a rivalry between a new character, and actually Storm was a well-developed character. He was introduced. McQueen was able to know who he really was. We saw how he was a complete different car, but he had similarities to McQueen. It was like a mirror, sort of. But what I really hated was Cruz Ramirez.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
So, do you want to go first?
Yeah. So, I believe that Cruz Ramirez is a character that shouldn't have been introduced at all. She doesn't... I believe that she doesn't deserve to be in the third movie. Because she took the story away from McQueen and more put it towards her.
Yeah.
Because she was a trainer at the Rusty's racing facility, and she said she wanted to become a racer. But it takes more than half an hour in a movie than to become a full-on stock car racer.
Yeah.
She isn't even built like McQueen either. She isn't even...
Mm-mm.
She doesn't even have stickers on the sides. She doesn't have anything like McQueen.
Mm-mm. Yeah, another thing is the story... even the trailers, it surrounded McQueen and Storm in a rivalry. McQueen's job was to beat Storm and continue his racing career. However, Cruz Ramirez, at the end, she was the one that beat Storm, not McQueen. And that was a total blowout because you introduced a character... That's supposed to be a side character, not a durotagonist, but durotagonist. It's
okay.
Someone that's with the protagonist, like,
okay.
Yeah, kind of like a sidekick. So she took that role. However, it's supposed to be just McQueen and Storm, not her getting involved with the race, and. She's his trainer, however, she has no experience at all. And another thing is, before she got her first script, she was on the simulator, and her top speed was 193 miles per hour. But on the beach, Hamilton, he calculated McQueen's speed, and it was 198. So McQueen's faster than her. However, how does that explain her beating Storm if he's much faster than her? That makes no sense. And another thing is, if McQueen was able to get repaired from his wreck, then why couldn't he got upgraded?
Yeah.
That's the big thing.
Yeah, he was basically put to the back to stop when he was crashed in the third movie.
Yeah, but he should
stripped
yeah.
of his paint.
Yeah, he should have gotten upgrades. And another thing, I know planes is out of the box here,
yeah.
but it's still in the same world. But Dusty was like, he had his own mechanic friend, right? And he was able to get more speed.
Mm-hmm.
So how come only on planes Dusty was able to get more faster, but McQueen, he's in the same world, but no mechanic got more upgrades. So why did Pixar use that instead of using it in the Cars franchise to make it more realistic? Like, you see what I mean?
Yeah.
So, but before you hit dislike or tell us comments like, no, you're all wrong, this is just our opinion, guys. There's no hate here.
Yeah.
You guys are able to enjoy Cars whenever you like, but we're just speaking out what we really think.
We're telling our opinions from watching the entire franchise 1, 2, and 3,
yeah.
and possibly 4.
And you can agree with us, but you could also disagree, but bygones be bygones.
Yeah.
So.
We're all entitled to our own opinions, and these are our opinions.
Yeah. Definitely. All right. What's our conclusion?
My final thoughts about it is, yes, I believe that Pixar did the best with Cars 1, and Disney should have stayed out of it. Cars 1 was the best, and Cars 2 and 3 were underwhelming and didn't fit the story.
Yeah. Another thing is, Cars 1 is the original. It's what introduces the entire world, how things work. However, Cars 2 and Cars 3, they're extra stories. But another thing about movies is if the first one's good, that means the second and the third one have to be the same, or else no one's going to watch it anymore. It
has to continue the story.
Yeah, it has to continue the storyline, or else it's just going to go bonkers. And
yeah.
Yeah, pretty much. So, yeah, but the original I'll always still love. It's a pretty good childhood movie. Very sweet, and very educational and inspiring.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I agree. All right, guys, that's our opinions about the Cars franchise, Cars 1, 2, and 3, and possibly 4 coming in the future.
Yep.
I hope you guys enjoyed this 40 subscriber appreciation video and seeing Bailey for the first time. Alright guys, so hit the like button if you liked it. Subscribe if you want more face-to-face content with us. Alright guys,
cheers!